Good evening, everybody. That's some old school. Welcome to the Yates Room. Welcome to another live by your host, Donald Yates. So I got some things that I want to go over with you folks tonight. And it's very important. Very important information. So I got a nice little selection playing from the 70s. For those of you who can go back that far. Anyway, I was born in 1969, but music like this was like in our time, in our house. You could really feel the soul inside the house. It was really a beautiful thing when you look back upon those days. Anyway, I want to dive right in and talk about a few issues that's come to our attention. And a lot of the things that I could discuss with you on live is basically for the benefit of the membership. I'm not here, you know, just to do show business or anything. I'm here to give you some information. And it's very important that you take some of this information down and take it as real as it is. I'm gonna have a discussion today about covering the cameras on your buses, our operations planning and what's coming. Janus versus AFSCME, Council 31, mass membership meeting, and I want to get into, and last but not least, I want to get into a question that was asked upon me about why Donald Yates got involved with the union. So without further ado, let me just thank everybody for coming on with me. Tuskegee Depot, Dwayne Ruffin, Flex from the Bronx, Scott Douglas, Doug Weiss. What's up, brothers? All right. Look, let me dive right in. Cameras. That's the future of New York City Transit. It ain't like it's really anything new, because cameras has always been in existence inside of the subway system. All right. If you look at certain storefronts, go down a certain block in a neighborhood, you may see rows of houses that have cameras. So cameras is nothing new. And while people may not like it, the cameras are on the buses, man. And we need to really pay attention to that and not cover them cameras. You know, covering those cameras is gonna cost people very huge, very big, very big. We got three cases right now just for people covering the camera. MTA bus got a case. Brooklyn Division got a case. MapStoa got a case. So, and all it is pure, you know, stupidity. Stupidity. Don't touch those cameras. Do not touch those cameras. Matter of fact, you can't touch anything on that bus or deface anything on that bus without it being a problem to you. All right? So I'm going to go through this line real quick, and I just want to tell people, don't touch those cameras. I want to implore unto you, do not touch those cameras. All right? We got cases possibly going to arbitration right now, right? For people's jobs. They're asking for termination, man. What is it worth touching those cameras? Do not touch those cameras. I say to you again, do not touch those cameras. We go around. We do shop gates. We have division meetings. We do these Facebook lives. We've been telling you guys, don't touch these cameras. Stay off the camera. Stay off those cameras. Just do your job. Do your job like you've been doing. They can't use those cameras unless it's an underlying event anyway. All right? It has to be an event. If you touch the camera, if you block the camera, there's a signal that's sent to East New York and to Broadway that says that there's a malfunction in the camera, which causes them to go to look at the camera. So when they look at the camera, they can see plain as day that you're blocking the camera, or that you're putting some obstruction on the camera, just like my hand is obstructing here. They can see that. You're putting the union in a compromising situation, ladies and gentlemen. Don't touch those cameras. Do not touch those cameras. All right? Moving on to my next order of business, and I think this is very important. We had an operations planning meeting last Monday. And what is the operations planning? Operations planning is contractual between the New York City Transit and the TWU Local 100, where they required to have a meeting with us and announce any changes that they want to do, such as service changes, service cuts, service adds, shuttle work. We get forecasts on all these things, and we have a right to challenge some of these things. And if they don't get, and just to let you know, if they don't give us an ops planning meeting before they cut, move routes to other depots, we can have all these things stop. The ops planning meeting is where it happens at. Now I want to focus on a particular. There's two things that got our attention. Fare collection. This guy came on and explained how fare collection is calculated. So they showed the fares being calculated in as far as MetroCard is concerned. They show some of the they had a graph showing how many people pay with MetroCard, how many people fare beat, how many fare boxes are actually broken, and what lines are performing or not performing based on fare box activity. And not only fare box activity, also bus track. Bus track is huge in this. People don't seem to get it. If you run uptown or across town, whichever route you're on, and you're hot, and you're not picking up, you're not only does the fare box tell that you're not picking up because there ain't no money being collected, but bus track sees exactly what's going on. And then even if you are picking up, they're examining the fare so technically, because they're looking at where you're picking up people and doing a guesstimation based on bus track and based on fare media, right? We all think it's bullshit, by the way, just so you know. We think it's bullshit. But this is what's been delivered to us. And just think about this. We're in a room full of managers, or maybe they're not even managers. In my opinion, they're a bunch of nerdy folks that sit in front of a computer and calculate how they can cut your job. And I need our membership to realize that. That's what these people do at ops planning, especially in areas of where people need the service. Now that brings me to my next point. The M4 out of Manhattanville Bus Depot. They want this. Okay, first of all, there's some things going on the M4 route. There's a proposal from DOT where they want to close off 32nd Street. 32nd Street is the hub on the M4. That's considered Penn Station over there. Let me cut that short. I want to answer Vanessa Jones' question. First of all, good evening, sister. Could the manipulation of the cameras put other operators at risk? And quite honestly, I don't think it could put anybody at risk. However, once it goes through the route, the disciplinary route, right? And we know that arbitration set precedence. If we get a bad decision out of arbitration for one of our members who messed with the cameras, then what will happen is that's how we put each other at risk. Because now you didn't set the parameters for if you touch a camera, if you do a blockage of a camera, maybe if we lose, chances could fire you. And mind you, just so we're clear about one thing, we know that if you mess with those cameras, there's definitely a penalty coming. So anything outside of 30 days, anything better than a 30-day suspension is a win for the union, because that's the only thing that I believe they would offer at this point in time. All right? And we don't believe that a 30-day suspension or dismissal is not a good punishment for what they deem to be the crime. All right, Sister Jones, I just wanted to answer that question. And I'm going to revert back to what's going on the M4. So the M4, Penn Station, DOT wants to do some type of pedestrian mall air over there. So they want to totally shut the street down, which would affect the bus from even going over there anymore. So now we already, from years past, that route went from the Cloisters area down Fort Washington Avenue. It went down Broadway. And I just, want you to kind of feel in your mind who this route services. All right. So down Fort Washington Avenue, the 160th Street, down Broadway to 110th Street, across 110th Street to Fifth Avenue, down Fifth Avenue to 34th Street, down 34th Street to 7th Avenue, and then 32nd Street will be the final destination on that route. Now, in recent years, they shorted the M4 down to 37th Street to make a turn there instead of 34th Street because DOT has created some type of unsafe acts the way they're doing their streets and their lanage. So what they've done is they had no choice but to move the M4 to 37th Street, where now it goes to 37th Street, it turns down 7th Avenue, which happens to be a big hazard and a lot of congestion for our operators over there. So now that they want to close 32nd Street, and I need this word spread like wildfire, because if it can happen to remember one thing, you could be in Michael J. Quill, you could be in Tuskegee, Mother Claire, hell, you could be anywhere in the system. Once they mess with a line, it affects your seniority across the board. You may not realize it up front, but see, I look at the big effects on these things. So now what they want to do, they want to close off 32nd Street, right? And this is a proposal. So right away, we're telling ops planning that this is a bad idea, because number one, the line, a bus route is either performing or non-performing route, right? That's how they're gauged, performing or non-performing. So what is performing? Performing means they're picking up people. The route makes money. That's a performing line, and it's on time or close to schedule. That's a performing route. A non-performing route is one, it's never making it on time. It doesn't make any money. It's a bunch of problems on the line, maybe fare beats and all of that stuff. That's a non-performing line. So now, essentially, what is being proposed is they want the M4 to be shorted down to 53rd Street and 5th Avenue and turn around and go uptown from there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what just happened? Let me tell you what just happened. I call it MTA racism. That's what just happened. For that proposal to even be considered is a direct effect on the Dominican and the African-American people who ride that line and expect to go down to Penn Station. That's a direct effect against those people. And who needs it the most? Those people. You got people who run down the line Fort Washington Avenue, take it all the way downtown, because that's all they know. Now what they want to do is they want to kick you off of 53rd Street. They expect you to run into a train. They don't know if you're elderly. They don't know what your problem is. Or they want you to go transfer to another bus now and increase your traveling time to your location. It's a bad decision. Why? Because what they're going to make the M4 do is they're going to turn that route into an unperforming line. Now, I just want you guys who are bus enthusiasts, wrap your mind around that. All right, try to wrap your mind around that. What's performing and what's non-performing? Okay, so this is on my watch. I'm the division chairman of Manhattan, so this is on my watch. What do I intend to do about it? Well, I'm starting it right now. I'm letting you guys know what's going on. I intend on getting our political action involved, and I intend on doing all I need to do to make some noise about what this really is. Because this is about cuts, no matter what. It's about saving money and finding another way at the expense of people of color, unfortunately. And that's just what it is. You know, I'm one that keeps it real, and that's what it is. All right? Sorry for my passion tonight, but that's what it is. Has anyone? Here's a pop question for everybody. Janus versus AFSCME. Has anybody bothered to look up the ramifications of Janus versus AFSCME? All right, and I hope you have, because that's what I'm trying to order everybody to get on here and do their own research to see what's happening. All right, AFSCME versus Janus versus AFSCME. All right, that's Mark Janus versus AFSCME, Council 31. That whole thing is about putting, does the union have a right to do automatic checkoff? All right, that's all this thing is about. And Mark Janus believes that it's a First Amendment, we're violating his First Amendment by collecting union dues and being different politically than what his thoughts might be. And in New York City, at least in our union dues support our union hall and all the resources that go along with it. Look up the word resources. Don't make me explain it, because resources is about money. Money, money, money. What your money pays for. What your union dues pay for. So that's resources. Resource. Your unions pay for lawyers. Your union pays salaries. Your union pays for negotiations. Your union pays for a lot of different stuff. What Mark Janus is actually talking about is what the Political Action Fund supports. Two different things. But because of the way that the government works and the Supreme Court works, we're expecting to have a bad decision on that. So we want our members to get ready and make sure that you pay your union dues. Of course, you're going to hear the naysayers. Oh, F the union. Union don't do shit for me. The union don't do this. The union did it. The union is a sellout. The union this. The union that. Hold up. Last time I checked, y'all were part of the union. So how the hell did you separate yourself from the union at a time where you just don't want to put out no money? That's crazy to me. That's crazy. I grew up in a union household. I know what the union paid for. I know what it pays for. It the union puts you on an even playing field with a lot of the CEOs out there who want to make sure that the things that we get in our contracts, the things that we get passed in legislation, don't happen. If you don't pay your dues, you're going to see unions go down the tubes, pensions go down the tube, workers' compensation go down the tubes, or injured workers. You're going to see a lot of negativity, and then you're going to say, whoa, what the hell happened? Well, what happened is People ain't paying their freaking dues. You got to pay your union dues. Period. I don't care if you don't like me. Vote me out if you don't like me. Vote me out if you feel I'm not doing a good job. All right? But at the end of the day, you got to pay your union dues. Everybody's got to pay their union dues to keep this union going. That's Janus versus AFSCME. Look it up. All right? Union meetings. You want to change things around here? You want to be involved with things around here? Then you guys should come to your union meetings and make the change at your union meetings. Make your motions. And my division meetings is Robert's Rules of Order strictly. So you get a play to say whatever you want to say and motion the body. And at some point we have a vote on the motion. We do that in our division meetings. So come on down. You want to see change? Do it at the division meeting. That's what it's all about. Let me take a little break here. I know I'm going a little passionate today, but excuse me. I'm just a passionate dude. I want to shout out a few people. Felix Baez, good evening, brother. Seamus, good evening. Calodro, good evening. Joseph DePola in the house. That's our safety from MapStore. Good evening, brother. MapStore Maintenance. Eugene Foster, how you doing, sis? Pablo, hey, what's up? Pablo, what's good? Catherine Gonzalez, how you doing? Gerald Ellis, how you doing? Nadine, what's up? Mackenzie, how you doing? Vanessa Jones, already spoke to you, but how you doing? Anthony DeSico, how you doing, brother? Jumpstepper. Yes, sir, I'm shouting you out. You said I don't talk to you? I'm talking to you now. Good evening, sir. How you doing? I want to read William Calodro's question. Why would any members mess with those cameras? Brother, I don't know. That's some craziness to me. Mackenzie says that would be a terrible idea. We pick up so many people at Penn Station. That's correct. That's what they did with the M. I know, Pablo. And that's what they did with the M6. And ultimately, they was able to cut the 6. But you see what happened later. They reinvented themselves and came up with a new line. The 55? I forget what line that was that they created. It was the 55 to make the trip all the way down there to the South Ferry area. And that was the line that they cut years ago, was the M6. They ended up putting it back. Kyrene Wilson, good evening. Kyrene Wilson asks, I wonder what other run they trying to cut. Nadine, yes, but they realized the error and brought it back. That's right, M55 is what I just said. Pablo De Villa, and that was after 6 years. Tony Aiken, what's up, D? What's up, T? William Calogero, can you touch a little on women that are pregnant and still working? Listen, if you're pregnant, go see your chairman, all right? And see if they can find you some light duty, all right? Nobody wants a lawsuit. I'm pretty sure that they'll look out. We've looked out for all our women in MapStore that we knew about who was pregnant, all right? Flex. Mark Janus is just, that's right. You hit it on the head. Janus is a cell among many more. They have been attacking union middle class and poor class people over the 60 plus years. Ray Vega, what's up? Hello. Anyway, moving on. Union meetings. You must attend your union meetings. Come to your union meeting. That's where we're going to make business. We're going to create business. We're going to move forward with an agenda. We do it at the division meetings. That's where it happens at. The mass membership meeting is coming up December 9th. It's going to be at the New York Marriott at the Brooklyn Bridge. The doors will open up at 11 o'clock, and you can meet and greet the officers. The meeting will actually start at 1 o'clock. There'll be some giveaways there. Make sure you come on out. This is your meeting. This is your union. Come on out to your union. All right? And in closing, and I told you, I never make them fast, but in closing, I was asked why I got involved in the union. All right. And I want to answer that. I was actually asked by one of my daughters why I got involved in the union. And my answer is basically the same as a preacher preaching a sermon in church. You have to be genuinely interested in people if you want to be successful. People can generally see a fraud. Don't let that go over your head. There's people out here that's running around saying they can do a better job as the president of this local. They can do a better job. Well, the democracy allows people to step up to the plate and try your luck. But let me tell you something, people. Mama didn't raise no fool. You need experience at the helm. You don't need rookies at the helm. You put a rookie at the helm, you will see. You will see. All that mouthy stuff and whatever you say on social media and press and the papers, it sounds good. But when you got members' lives in your hands, you got to make decision that represents those members' lives. And you want to make sure that you don't put those members' lives in jeopardy. And I'm going to close with that, brothers and sisters. I'm going to give you a little song from the 70s. A lot of this music came from my father in his old 8-track tapes. Y'all feel me? Anyway, good night, everybody. Have a blessed week. And hit me up. Oh, before I close out, let me just say one thing. I have a YouTube channel. YouTube. Look me up on YouTube. I'm Union Rep. One word, Union Rep 100. Union Rep and then 100 with Donald Yates. Subscribe to my page. Like the page. I'm trying to bring out education. I may not be the smoothest guy that can do it, but I'm definitely out here doing it. So subscribe to my page on YouTube. All right? Union Rep 100 with Donald Yates. Have a good night, everybody.